Are you looking for a great B cam? Tell you what, I picked up the Sony ZV-1. Why did I pick up this camera in 2021? Let's talk about it next. Today, I'm going to talk to you guys about the Sony ZV-1 and why I picked up this camera in 2021. First off, this is a small, compact camera capable of shooting 4K at 24 and 30 frames per second. It can also do slow motion at 1080p at both 60 and 120. This does have a 1-inch sensor and it does come with an equivalent lens of 24 to 70 millimeters. Maybe a little too tight for vlogging, but we'll get to that later in the video. So why would you want a small compact camera? Well, I can tell you that if you're somebody who might be a little embarrassed to be out there vlogging in public, this small camera is gonna look very discreet as you're out there vlogging. This is a small compact camera. As you can see, when it's fully open, it's very small. Most people will just think that you're out there just doing regular photos, regular video. They won't think that you're some YouTuber or somebody who's very invasive. So if you're just out there with a little point and shoot camera, you just look like every other tourist that's out there. You're able to go to more places. You're not going to get harassed because, like I said, it's just a small point and shoot camera. People are going to look at you and they're going to think to themselves, that's just a small camera. The other nice thing is this is small, compact, 4K goodness right in your pocket. So you can slip this thing right into your pocket. You're running and gunning with 4K video no matter where you go. Yes, it's a 1-inch sensor. If you have enough light, if you're out vlogging during the day, you're going to be able to get some great images out of this camera. What are some of my plans with it? Well, first and foremost, great B camera. This thing will do wonders for great top-down shots. It's light, it's portable, so you're able to put it up onto a tripod and have this thing just easily dangle over the top. It's got the fully articulating screens. When you have it up there, you can actually see what's going on down below. So this way you know whatever you're shooting underneath is definitely in focus. But another reason is, it's just a good little fun family camera. So if you're looking to get some good image quality and you don't want to lug around a big camcorder, this camera, like I said, you can toss it in your pocket and you got 4K goodness right at your fingertips. You can also do some slow motion. So if you want to videotape your kids in slow motion, you got that right here with this camera. And like I said, it's a good cheap B camera that produces excellent image quality. You can have this thing off on a stick over on the side and maybe have it zoomed in and get just the head of your subject. So you got your full frame rigged out here and then you got your ZV-1 maybe off to the side here and you're getting some of that 4K crispiness out here on the side and you're basically got yourself a B cam. Without having to carry around a whole bunch of extra gear. This thing is also a great point and shoot camera. Yes, it doesn't have an EVF, but let's be completely honest. Most people are used to taking video and pictures with their cell phone. This is no different. You flip this sucker around and now you got yourself a point and shoot camera. Now it does have a built-in ND filter in it. And I'll be honest, it works pretty well. But if you're really out shooting during the middle of the day, it's not gonna take care of all that light. You're still gonna have to stop down to maybe an F4 or an F5.6. So you may wanna get a variable ND filter for this thing, or I'll talk about it towards the end of the video about what I use, especially when you're out there vlogging, how you can ultimately get a better, wider angle and be able to put some ND filters on there. It does have a nice power zoom, so you can zoom in and out, get pretty tight. It also offers clear image zoom, so you can do clear image zoom with this thing and get an extra 1.5 times zoom when you are shooting in 4K. So guys, if we're meeting for the first time, my name's Brian, the camera guy. On my channel, I review Sony cameras and lenses. If that's something you're into, do me a favor, go ahead, smash that like button, hit that subscribe button, and ring that bell notification so you don't miss out on my future videos. Now, let's get back to the review. Now, the other reason why I picked this up is this comes with Sony's full picture profile. So you got S-Log 2, 3. You also have HLG 1, 2, and 3. I personally shoot HLG 3 on my Sony A7C, but with this camera, a lot of times I'm shooting HLG 2. It just seems to be a little bit of a better codec when shooting on a 1-inch sensor. Smaller the sensor, the less dynamic range you really have to work with. So unless you nail that exposure just right, I find that the HLG 2 works the best. Gives you that dynamic range, preserves those highlights, captures those shadows without giving you a ton of noise. But I can also tell you that the standard picture profile does do an excellent job. So in a pinch, if you don't want to mess around with color grading, the standard picture profile, either the PP1 or even the PP3, does an excellent job. I do recommend switching your picture profile to neutral. This way it does kind of give you more of a natural look. I do find that the standard picture profile with the standard kind of color setting does make you look a little too pink. Now, if you are feeling so inclined, you can definitely use the S-Log 2 and 3 in this camera. The downside is that S-Log 2, you have to get that exposure just right. And with S-Log 3, a lot of times it will break down due to that smaller sensor. If you're gonna try something and you wanna get a little bit more dynamic range, my recommendation is to use the HLG 3 picture profile. That one gives you pretty close to the same dynamic range as the S-Log 3, but it is a little bit more forgiving on shadows. Definitely helps a little bit with the highlights. Now, if you're shooting in low light or very close to no light, you're definitely gonna wanna use no picture profile. This camera is a 1-inch sensor. It's not gonna give you great low light performance. If you go with no picture profile, you don't have to overexpose. So in many cases with a lot of these picture profiles, you're gonna have to overexpose your footage, and then in post, you're gonna bring it down to help preserve those shadows. If you go with no picture profile in low light, that's gonna help make this camera work a lot better in low light situations. Now, if you're liking this review, go ahead, comment down below and let me know, are you looking to pick up the Sony ZV-1? And as always, if you are looking to pick up any of the products ever talked about in any of my videos, there are affiliate links down below. I appreciate you using those links as they do help support this channel. Now, another reason why I picked up this camera is this works as a great B cam to my Sony A7C. This camera shares the same color science as the Sony A7C and the Sony A7S III. You can easily match up this camera with either one of those two cameras, and you're going to get fantastic quality footage that matches perfectly well in post color grading. Another reason why I picked up this camera is because it doubles as a webcam. So I literally transport this thing back and forth from work every single day, and I use this thing as a webcam, and it gives me some nice crispy images. When I use it as a webcam, I just use the USB cord that came provided with the camera. Now, I do find that some micro USB cords do not have compatibility to run the live streaming software that's in this camera. I will put a link down below to where you can get a 6-foot cable that I have found that works perfectly well. It keeps the camera charged, and it does keep it working as a web camera throughout the day. Now, I've been using this thing at work every day for about a month now, and I can tell you that I've gotten a lot of compliments. It's a lot better than that little USB camera that you're gonna put on top of your monitors. I also picked up a tripod stand that I put behind my monitors to help support and carry this camera. I'll link that down in the description below so you can pick that up. The beauty of this camera as a webcam is you don't need a capture card. So like I said, you can run it right from the USB right to the computer, and then you can use it with Zoom. I also use Microsoft Teams at work. Basically, you can just use this as a webcam for whatever operation you're looking to do. You're saving yourself anywhere from $100 to $200 by not needing a capture card. This thing can run all day long with that micro USB. It's definitely gonna stay well charged, but that leads me to one of the cons of this camera. The battery life sucks. It's terrible. Gives you about an hour, maybe an hour and 15 minutes if you're running 4K. You're definitely gonna wanna pick up some extra batteries. Also, speaking of swapping out batteries, this tripod screw right here, it does interfere with this door. If it is mounted to a tripod, you do have to take off the tripod mount every single time you need to get at this door. And if you're changing batteries quite a bit, that's going to be a problem. So I highly recommend getting that longer micro USB cable so you can put this thing up on sticks and run this camera pretty much indefinitely with that micro USB cable. Also, another con, this thing is, like I said, a 1-inch sensor, so it's pretty small. It is going to do terrible in low light. Don't recommend using this camera in low light. Make sure you have a lot of light. Now, if you have a lot of light, camera's gonna work perfectly fine. It's gonna be a great camera for you. It's gonna give you great image quality and a small compact body. The other piece is, I find once you get over 1600 ISO with this camera, you do start to get a little bit of that grain in the footage. Highly recommend, if you can, keep this thing at 1600 or less. If you have to, 3200 is acceptable. You might wanna run some denoiser on this. Try and keep it 1600 or less. That's going to get you the best image quality possible. I'm going to show you what I also use to kind of get that wider vlog format, because if you do put this thing on, it has active stabilization, so it's really going to smooth out the footage, and it comes with gyro stabilization. So Sony does offer Catalyst Browse, which is a free software that allows you to put your footage in there and it will go ahead and stabilize it. It's way better than Warp Stabilizer, but it does crop in, same as the active stabilization. What I'm going to do is show you exactly what I'm using. zooms in to get a wider field of view out of this camera. This is the Ulanzi wide angle lens for the Sony ZV-1. This thing does help get your ZV-1 out to an 18 millimeter equivalent. It's actually two lenses in one. This is a macro lens, so you can get up nice and tight with some macro shots. And then you screw this on and this gives you that wide angle. I'm gonna throw this on the camera and I'm gonna hold it out and show you exactly what it looks like with the active stabilizer on without the lens. And then I'll go ahead and I'll hold this lens up and show you what it looks like with this lens on. Okay, so this is what the ZV-1 will look like with HLG2 picture profile. I got active stabilizer on. It's really, really cropped in. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna throw this lens up here. Look at how much wider that looks. That's without this Ulanzi lens. This is with the Ulanzi lens. Definitely does a much better job. I'm still holding this all the way out. Hopefully with the Sony ZV-2, Sony ends up doing more of a 16 to 50 millimeter lens. That would definitely help out to eliminate the tightness that this thing has. I'm gonna go ahead and screw this thing on. So there you go. There's the full image quality that you're gonna get using this Ulanzi lens. As you can see, you don't really lose much image quality when using this lens. It does a very good job. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn it back over to the regular cam. So if you have any questions or comments about the camera, go ahead, leave them down below. I've been using this camera now for about a month, so I can totally try and help you out with any questions that you may have. If you like this video, I'm sure you're gonna like the video on the screen now. It's about another camera for the Sony system. Make sure you go ahead and click on that video, and I'll see you on that next video. Before you leave, don't forget to like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Brian, out.